Welcome to ISTV English News. I'm Dhania. Let's take a look at the top stories first. Students threaten to resume normal class at educational institutions if the government fails to revoke the order for holiday within 24 hours. And a local iron industry launches Eco Multi Stove that can produce heat by using charcoal dust. The news in detail. Students of various schools have taken strong exception to the state government's policy of closing schools and colleges in the state to subdue the ongoing agitation of JC-ILPS. Following 3 days of closure of schools and colleges, angry students of Ibothon Sana Girls Higher Secondary School have decided to resume class at the school if the government fails to change its decision and revoke the order for closure of the schools and colleges at the earliest. Addressing the media persons at the school at Uripok, General Secretary of the Students' Union, S. Nikita Chanu, said, "Indefinite closure of schools and colleges is not a right decision of the state government." She further said, in his speech during the Independence Day held at 1st MR Ground, Chief Minister O. Ibobi said that students must continue their studies even in the wartime. To the contrary, it is quite surprising to impose indefinite closure of schools and colleges in the state. Besides, the students are having apprehension that the syllabus may not be fully covered during the academic session. The step taken by the state government is highly condemnable and is against the students' community. All the students arrested during the agitation will be released without any condition, and the union will continue normal class at the school if the government fails to revoke the closure of schools and colleges within 24 hours, she warned.
Tilato ke baisi yanindel maramatuna pungkun marigi manungda hanagi matogumna mahiroi singbu laitama phangan jagadi akoina mandi nimit halali ba mandi sidaki amuhana hanagi matogumna laitama na ba Satra Singh hanagi matogumna school garakna ba na haijai masida akoina lecture wa yaba sida school gi Satra Singh amadi oja sing ju puna support au bina bani sing jari aduga aroi boina Fazin ke pasar tracing tu, fazin pun itu dalam ke pasar tracing tu condition yang tiada kena thado biar nampak hasil.
For the first time in Manipur, a special kind of stove to be called Eco Multi Stove has been manufactured by the Kesham Sheet Metal and Iron Works located at Sagolband Ingudam Lairak in Imphal West. This stove can be used in cooking or boiling water by burning charcoal dust that we usually throw away as useless waste. Our joint editor Takelambam Sunil Kumar and cameraman Jeevan met the proprietor of Kesham Sheet Metal and Iron Works, Kesham Gopendro, to inquire about the newly produced stove. He said, in financially backward Manipur, there are a number of poor people who try to eke out a living by running small hotels and can't afford to use cooking gas. They use charcoal stoves for cooking food. However, people throw away charcoal dust as useless waste. With an objective of not wasting the charcoal dust, instead cook food with it, thus saving hard-earned money of the people, the new kind of stove had been designed and manufactured, Gopendro said.
So he can give among the gi, a woman pussy, I'm the lara valiba, a palam de gilaiva, the LPC, a top and wine wiva, induction heater at the auto, Pesayam consumto, a money pool lara, can they want in a lady thing of the new wife with Alang itu saya mati macam mayam sok ternalar ada lagi sak sengda senggu itu thalar ambu mayam. Mungkin yang itu betul na masih thal lagi di. Dua ayam itu fangba pesa susu tinggi dabo. Aduh nang saya ki fail kita betul pesa cang cang selam ambu mayam tu. Lah ibu praja lah ibu lagi pesa. Kemudian ada ikhwan lagi biawe putih dabo. Saat thunun ambu ni na tau ke borang ampai ke sok lagi wasiat kulla selam. Madu ingat si bokong umdu. Aduh kumba wakulun mayam tu na ini he. Nami gay di. Sungguh, masa gila, ada yang kena tu posis putuh ke hari wakil saya. Ibu anda saya hobi bahasa ini bunga amat teram. Ibu anda kanjil aku ni ada bunga sidi yang warna warna dengan hari balai yang saya ini sahabat kami zaman ini aku ini sungguhnya itu kampung singgi. Warna zaman ni nak hajar ni.
The manufacturer claimed that with just a little charcoal dust, the stove, which costs only 2,000 rupees, can easily cook food for 6 persons within 10 minutes. The flame of the stove can be either bigger or smaller by using a regulator which propels a fan. The regulator functions with the help of an adapter which is powered by either battery or electricity. Proprietor Gopendro, who is a graduate, took up the profession of iron works as a self-employment. he gives employment to some other people also. He had earlier manufactured eco-cylindrical stove. In trying to make his work successful, he has sought financial help from only the Women's Cooperative Bank. He has not received any help from the government authorities so far.
Financial help ti help ti ai sumphang mak phang de habi adu government dei scheme phang de ngasi bawda ndi matang de ai kanu yong jare masi yam na asama ga loina na ai akoi government na han ki sahi 2014 jita mak pangthuk ki giba akoi gi PMEGP gi ai loan me apply dau jare amandu bu ai yam thina waro tase anu aje de ai punji za loan amona tharo ga ai khanjai maram de kai na ka ai su ye thau si moi hangbi yo nang kamai sui kamai tawi nang kam kai ni question am bio question manga ma ta ma ma da ina question ma khumog da matam da question du khumba ngam da ma ma kan ai loan phaw da ni ai khanja ge adu na te nang roll number kya no nang paisa kya amount apply to adi ga apo ma kai nang sui thok ji kai no si question ahum ji hang ni question ahum ji ange ai khum ai na thai paisa ai 5 lakhs thai adu ai sian na hai adi roll number kya no ai adu roll number hai hai bu sing adu di khalak ka do khalo hang ni question no kai no ai gyan ma
He further said that he wants the government to lend financial help to people like him who work honestly.
Haitare loan gi khutangda de gya to to pamong da thadabi ba pacha sing si thawana sujari ba lai ba khoi gum da thadabi dana akoi ni puthuk sei po se he na puthuk bang ngam na ba ga me na thamo se ang na mate pang bi ra gati gyas le bangam da nungai di khang su ngam da adu gum mi sing da akoi gi post na sina hala ga moi da su yam na nungai ba awa ba le hen da na ba kona ba da mate pang bi ha na ga me da masim ta ga thamja
MLA of Sagolban Assembly Constituency, R.K. Imo, along with Director of Art and Culture, Dr. K. Sobita Devi, and Superintendent of Archaeology, K. Dinamani, today jointly inspected the ancient peepal tree, popularly known as the Kongnang Hogaibi, growing at Wahingbam Lekai, Sagolban Road, on the National Highway 37, to protect and preserve it as a historical monument under the Manipur Ancient and Historical Monument and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act 1976. Director K. Sobita said, the site where the tree is growing is the place where Maharaja Charai Rongba was laid to rest. It is very important that the place is protected under the Act. MLA R.K. Imo said, as soon as the state government declares the site as a protected area, necessary development will be taken up in consultation with the Chief Minister. A notice had been issued on March 19 by the Deputy Secretary of Art and Culture, Government of Manipur, Kinjal Hai Kipgen, informing that the government is interested in making the site where the Kongnang Hogaibi is growing a protected historical monument area. The notice also informed the public that any objection may be raised with regard to the plan within 2 months after the notice was published, he said. He also said that the place has remained a garbage dump for a long time.
Bijo Govinda ga adegi thanga pat ka yaw da singot si hai da adu musical ma fan gi ma khada singot da na hsi yon ba cm gi ma gi pero gi de lai re aga da kona kam ba fan da kamai sa ga dino hai ba si po chi den no to boi wa adu lai ba si coming season si manung chi da pa na su awna bi gon ba cm da kan na ko jo hai jari de gi department gi saita gi su si coming season si da coming program sahi gi 14 15 si da ji happy ra ga lotion bi ba ᱡᱟᱛᱚ ᱵᱩᱥᱤ ᱫᱟ ᱢᱟᱛᱮᱝ ᱯᱟᱢᱵᱤ ᱵᱟᱫᱩᱜᱟ ᱯᱮ ᱢᱟᱱᱤᱯᱩᱨ ᱜᱤ ᱪᱚᱣᱵᱟ ᱥᱩᱜᱩᱢᱵᱟ ᱦᱟᱭᱜᱟ ᱛᱨᱟᱢᱮ ᱟᱢᱵᱤ ᱡᱮᱢ ᱫᱚ ᱢᱟᱢᱩ ᱚᱭᱜᱟ ᱫᱚ ᱡᱟᱜᱟ ᱥᱤᱭᱩᱡᱤ ᱯᱮ ᱱᱚ ᱢᱚᱛᱛᱟᱱᱟ ᱠᱟᱭᱫᱟᱱᱟ ᱞᱮᱜᱤ ᱡᱮ ᱥᱤᱢᱵᱟᱞᱟᱜᱟ ᱟᱭ ᱢᱮᱭᱟᱢᱟ ᱢᱟᱱᱫᱟ ᱠᱟᱭᱫᱟᱱᱟ ᱞᱮᱜᱤ ᱡᱮ ᱥᱤᱢᱵᱟᱞᱟᱜᱟ ᱦᱤᱥᱴᱚᱨᱤᱠᱮᱞᱤ ᱤᱢᱯᱚᱨᱴᱮᱱᱴ ᱞᱮᱜᱤ ᱵᱟ ᱥᱟᱭᱴᱤ ᱟᱯᱚᱭᱱᱟ ᱢᱟᱢᱟᱝ ᱛᱷᱟᱨᱟᱜᱟ ᱢᱟᱯᱷᱟᱢ ᱥᱤᱫᱟ ᱟᱫᱚ ᱵᱟᱭᱫᱟᱜᱤ ᱢᱟᱭᱟᱭ ᱚᱭᱱᱟ ᱥᱩ ᱞᱮᱜᱤ ᱵᱟ ᱯᱟᱭᱜᱤ ᱯᱷᱟᱱᱩᱝ ᱥᱤ ᱞᱮᱜᱤ ᱵᱟ ᱥᱩᱢᱵᱟ ᱦᱤᱥᱴᱚᱨᱤᱠᱮᱞ ᱥᱟᱭᱴᱤ ᱟᱯᱷᱟᱵᱟ ᱞᱟᱢᱵᱤ ᱢᱮᱫᱟ ᱢᱮᱭᱟᱢᱜᱤ ᱠᱚᱱᱡᱟᱨᱵ ᱛᱚᱨᱮ ᱯᱨᱤᱡᱟᱨᱵ ᱛᱚᱨᱮ ᱦᱟᱵᱤ ᱫᱚ ᱢᱟᱢᱟᱝ ᱛᱷᱟᱨᱟ ᱯᱚᱭᱱᱟ ᱩᱱᱤᱝ ᱵᱟᱜᱤ ᱢᱟᱥᱤᱜᱤ ᱮᱢ ᱥᱤᱫᱟ ᱱᱟ ᱯᱚᱭᱪᱤ
United Friends Library and Club organized a free Ayush medical camp in association with Ayush Hospital JNIMS at Lamboi Kongnangkhong today. Dr. A. Guneshwar Sharma of State Ayush Office, Porompat, founder member of the club, Chongtham Thoiba Singh, Doctor of Ayush N.G. Mema and other officials took part in the camp. In all, 15 doctors examined around 200 people during the camp. Secretary of the club, Basanta, said the camp is organized for the people.
Ayush treatment program koi campaign la se koi lekai sida sing chaudna koi skill gi aduga tonga tonga ma leina kaya ama hong hama na singba alum lai hong na singba kaya tokiba sigi de makta koina praja sigi de makta club asina agamba khra dang waru su mating pangna no haidina khoi ayus constant po pang ki makha da jenis ki makha da leiba asumba department sigi makha da koina kasi ki sulba cream treatment program ma sinja bani.
On the other hand, Awang Kuno Young Development Association and Shija Hospital jointly organized a free medical camp at the premises of the club today. Many local residents were treated in the camp. In today's national and international news, expressing concern over corruption in the judiciary, Chief Justice of India R.M. Lodha asserted that independence of judiciary is non-negotiable. As things change and economy grows, corruption also grows. Don't do anything that brings corruption in judiciary, he said. He also warned judges to be wary of people who tempt them for unlawful acts. There are people who play trick on judges and are prepared to tempt judges and please them. We have to ensure that corruption is eradicated in all forms in judiciary. The CJI said that the judiciary has inherent strength and no effort will succeed in taking away judicial independence. Independence of judiciary leads to confidence in mind of public that it will come to their aid and rescue if any wrong is committed by executive, he said. Voting on Saturday began on a brisk note in by-elections to 3 Lok Sabha and 33 assembly constituencies spread across 10 states, seen as a test of Narendra Modi government's popularity, especially as BJP braces for polls in 2 states next month. Voting began on a brisk note in the Uttar Pradesh by-polls to the 11 assembly and 1 parliamentary seat. While balloting was slow owing to a drizzle in the Lucknow East constituency, long lines of voters were seen outside polling stations in Charkhari, Sirathu, Balha, Rohaniya, Nighasan, Saranpur city, Bijnor, Thakurdwara, Noida and Hamirpur. Voting was being held under tight security in Mainpuri, the lone Lok Sabha constituency that went to polls Saturday. Mocking Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Acche Din slogan, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee said, weeping time has come for people as resources of the country are being sold to foreign powers in the name of FDI by the BJP-led government at the centre. Before coming to power, there were slogans like Acche Din, good times are ahead. Now it seems weeping time has come for the people of India. In 100 days, there are 100 failures, Banerjee said during an interview. In the name of FDI, they have opened up railways, defense and many other sectors for FDI. We are against FDI and in favor of PPP. There should be a proper policy. I am not in favor of taking away jobs of the common man. Fuel prices are going up every day, she said. CBI Chief Ranjit Sinha has said that noted lawyer Prashant Bhushan cannot claim immunity from disclosing the name of a whistleblower who provided him the list of visitors to his official residence and demanded that he reveal his source. In his affidavit filed before the Supreme Court in response to the plea of Bhushan that Sinha be removed from the 2G scam probe in the wake of his allegations that he met accused and officials of accused companies at his residence, the agency chief said, it is not open to the lawyer to argue his case without disclosing the source from which he got the details of the visitors mentioned in their affidavit. He had filed this affidavit yesterday in response to plea of Bhushan, counsel for an NGO, Center for Public Interest Litigation, seeking his removal from 2G spectrum scam probe. When calamity strikes, it does not discriminate. This was on ample display when floods ravaged Kashmir. Along with civilian population, security forces deployed there from various parts of the country were also hit badly. They lost their belongings and their weapons were damaged or left useless after water entered their camps across the Kashmir Valley. Hundreds of AK rifles, INSAS rifles and SLR rifles along with their ammunition are still submerged at various places across the Kashmir Valley, so are bombs, hand grenades, etc. Some reports said 26 AK rifles from an army camp have been washed away in the floods. In the area of Gogji Bagh in uptown Srinagar, one of the worst hit parts of the valley, about 400 personnel of a central paramilitary force had to leave their camp after gushing waters engulfed it last Sunday night. After a decent performance in the recently concluded Glasgow Commonwealth Games, the Indian women hockey team is all geared for another challenge as they depart from here today for the upcoming Asian Games at Incheon, South Korea. Asian Games, scheduled from September 19 to October 4, will provide a platform for the Indian Eves to qualify for the 2016 Rio Olympics. At least 274 people have been killed and over 2 million affected in massive flooding triggered by heavy rain, monsoon rains in Pakistan, officials said today. The rains lashed vast areas of the country last week and since have stopped, but the floods triggered by the heavy showers are still out of control. And now let's take a look at the top stories once again. Students threaten to resume normal class at educational institutions if the government fails to revoke the order for holiday within 24 hours. And a local iron industry launches Eco Multi Stove that can produce heat by using charcoal dust. Thanks for joining us, and for more news updates, do keep watching ISTV News.